They don't have a druid. Rucko's literally playing druid right now. Yeah, I mean, they could do that, or they could play this composition. I mean, it's been working out for them so far in this tournament. It's one of the reasons why they're in the upper bracket. We'll just have to see, because I feel like in North America, Method Orange, their Demon Hunter Death Knight was basically the top-tier caliber. They were the gold standard. So if they can beat this team with this composition, that's really going to speak volumes.
All right, Mez taking a beating early on, but as the Unholy Death Knight, unlikely to die and easily recover now early on in the fight. Jamili under pressure, Roasties as well. Trill bouncing between the Windwalker and the Demon Hunter in tournament play. Definitely of the highest level, our reigning champions. Method Orange, game number one versus the Mew Mew Kitty Cats. The only two, well, I guess they're not the only team to beat Cloud9 now because Kolo has. So Cloud9 is going to have to go back to the drawing board for next week's tournament to try and see how they want to deal with the strategy that Never Lucky and Mew Mew Kitty Cats have brought, since they're essentially playing the same composition to beat them, that Fire Mage, Assassination Rogue, Holy Paladin. Trill is getting a lot of uptime right now, and Mew Mew Kitty Cats need to focus on either crowd controlling Trill or denying him from getting such a frequent amount of mana rifts, or Rub Cup will be out of mana very quickly.
Yeah, I mean, the most important thing we saw from Roasties, from Jamili, was landing the kidney shot on Trill. Every time Trill went for a stun, they would counter stun with either this, the kidney shot, or the lightning lasso. And they haven't been able to get too many of those counter stuns off right now. Trill, now that he's out of the kidney shot, is going to be feeling nice and healthy. Go sort of chase down Rub Cub, try to take him out of mana. But if we look, C2's actually a little bit behind, which is surprising. There's been good pressure on Mez during this game, a lot of offensive purges coming in from Jamili. And C2's been kind of struggling to maintain his mana in this game so far.
Although I think he may be sitting down for a drink and Rub Cub doesn't know where he is. Cedar getting a bit more mana. Trill being pressured at the moment, but really Jamili and Roasties have been hovering at very low health at this early stage in the game. It's not usual to see this much consistent pressure between these two teams. Rub Cub struggling. If Trill can make his way over for another mana rift, I mean, he's going to be at half mana already. Roasties the target at the moment. It looks like they're split damage dealing at the moment. Trill is kind of focusing down Roasties, and Mez is attacking Jamili. Now Trill switching some of those Fel Lances to Jamili instead. Interesting that he's running the Rain from Above on her talent, so he can fly into the skies and dish down some pain, but as soon as he's landed, he is the one feeling it.
Trill runs that talent more often than really anyway. I mean, sure, it's fun. And I think the reason why he does it is I feel like Trill is one of those players who really prides himself on doing max DPS. So being able to use that Rain from Above, it does provide a lot of bonus damage, but I'm not sure if it's necessarily the best talent. I mean, Trill obviously would know a lot better than I would, but it's not a talent you normally see other Demon Hunters run often.
Mana Rift used on Roasties. I mean, it does damage as well, I suppose. But now on cooldown, if they stun Rub Cub, Cedu stunned up. Mana surprisingly even. Still anyone's match.
Trill
blasted big damage here as they force Blur from Trill. Potentially even getting a kill in the future. Lightning Lasso, silence on Cedu. Perfect combo. Trill's in trouble. Holding on by a thread, landing a double stun of his own.
Nice.
Managing to recover as a result. It's very important to hit multiple targets with that Chaos Nova, as it will spawn souls on the ground, which you can pick up and heal yourself. So landing a stun on the two players, picking up a couple of the souls, allows Trill to easily stay alive.
Yeah, and good damage once again. Going to be cast out by Trill with that Rain from Above, doing damage to Rub Cub, doing damage to Jamili, putting out massive pressure for his team. Nicely done by Method Orange, by Trill. Now Jamili's in a little bit of trouble as they turn their attention over onto Mez, trying to get some counter pressure. Lightning Lasso used on Trill. Bit of a split strategy, split tactic coming in from Jamili, but the Lightning Lasso was used too early, and now Trill does not get denied on that Mana Rift. And I think this is a mistake. I feel like Mew Mew Kitty Cats was playing a little bit more sloppy than we saw them play on Friday, or on Saturday, sorry, yesterday when they were playing. They had a lot more counter stuns onto the Demon Hunters, but today it hasn't been that case. Trill has had a lot of opportunities to land those Mana Rifts, so that might be something they want to consider switching up.
Yeah, most definitely. If Rub Cub can maintain mana into dampening, then I see Mez as a target. Already actually using the Icebound Fortitude. Good pressure from M2KC so far. However, this composition doesn't end up working. I would like to see them try the Rogue Mage Druid in the strategy of running Feral Affinity and just running Cedu down on the healer, because that strategy has locked Europe out of even selecting the Demon Hunter Death Knight. I mean, we didn't see it even once, so it's obviously potent if this one doesn't end up working.
Yeah, look, Trill missed. Good pressure here on Jamili. Rub Cup, zero mana. He's completely zeroed out in this situation. CD goes for a drink, but they did stop it. Nicely done by Jamili. Really heads up play. If they can avoid CD ever drinking, maybe they can even out that mana lead. But the stun over on Rub Cup, he's completely mana rifted down once again. And Trill's just going to focus on maximum damage. Rosies has to be careful. He's not getting cleaved down too much in this particular game. CD in stealth right now. I think he's actually going for a drink. Is able to recover some of his mana. Let's see how much he can really get. And Method Orange now in a commanding lead. CD 50% mana. Gets the Iron Bark on Mez. I don't think Mez is going to go down outside of some sort of miracle Trill attempt by Jamili and Roasties. Trill is all over the map. Rain from above. I think this is actually going to be the killing blow on Jamili.
Trill is doing the most amount of damage. I want to see a damage meter. I swear for the last minute he's been doing like the combined damage of every member in the game.
And I feel like they could really test Sidu on that Restoration Druid, because as a healer that's playing sort of, I don't even want to call a Restoration Druid an alt for Sidu. I feel like, although a lot of people, yeah, a lot of people consider like Restoration Shaman Sidu's main. I think he's played literally every healer at BlizzCon. Like, at BlizzCon, yeah, I think he's played Priest, he's played Paladin, he's played Druid, Mistweaver Monk, Shaman. So, I mean, he can basically play any healer. And the one strategy I kind of want to see for M2KC change in this game is the counter stuns on Trill. That's what they were doing so well against Thug yesterday. Every single time Thug was going for those mana rifts, he'd get a stun, and then he would just get caught in a stun on that global. So he wasn't able to follow it up. Trill immediately taking so much damage. Sidu forced to use his Trinket and his Iron Bark. Kidney Shot once again going to be connecting. And M2KC, they're having much more of an explosive opener.
Yeah, this time around, M2KC are focusing on Trill. And they need to. They have to stop him from getting mana rifts on Rub Cub. Nice traveling storms, thunderstorm from Jamili. And it outranged
really
Trill's mana rift on the stun. It's all about denying as many mana rifts as possible, trying to burst down the Demon Hunter. And if you can't do it, hopefully getting deep enough into dampening to the point where you can do it. That is the main objective for M2KC. And then, of course, the main objective for Method Orange is just do damage to anything that moves and breathes and get as many mana rifts as possible on Rub Cub until Rub Cub's tapped out and his entire team is dead. So can M2KC play solid mana rift defense? Can they avoid them? Currently one being secured onto Rub Cub, so one already out of the way. No denial for that one. And it's even on mana because of the first Thunderstorm denial on the mana rift. Rub Cub's looking for crowd control. Mez saw this attack coming, though, and had the anti-magic zone, this purple shield where Trill is hiding inside of. This is protecting him from magical damage. Well done on Mez's part.
Yep, good backup from Mez. Good cooldown organization from Method Orange. Trill does get caught into a cyclone. Rubka's been trying to extend his mana. Once again, he's a little bit behind on Sidu, and Sidu's just going to be chasing him down. There's a bash. Trill looking for the mana rift. Is he going to be able to find it? Is Rub Cub going to be able to hold on to that precious mana? No. Trill does land the mana rifts, and this is what we're talking about. These consistent mana rifts is what has given M2KC so much trouble in the past. Mez has just been sitting on Jamili this entire game, shutting down every single one of those lightning lassos, and that is just such a powerful tool for the Elemental Shaman to start generating pressure for his team. If he's getting shut down on every lightning lasso by the Unholy Death Knight, then it just really limits the kill opportunity for M2KC.
We already significant lead. The mana rifts are sinking in. The denial is not there. This is not looking good for M2KC. Rub Cub's moving forward. He's trying to get some crowd control going. Going for a cyclone. Trill is actually pretty low on health. Possibility here for M2KC. As I say that, Trill just immediately ducking for cover, balancing both maximizing his damage and maximizing his defense to avoid death while his healer was crowd controlled. Once again, great play here on Method Orange's part. And if they play this well, I don't know if the Elemental Shaman Rogue is going to work. They've got a decent opportunity here to kill Trill. He's around half health, but Sidu denies it with Iron Bark. More than enough defense to keep him going. Rub Cub needs a drink. Sidu knows that. He repositions so that Rub Cub will never find a drink. Trill moves in for another mana. If they go for the Traveling Storms, unfortunately, the staircase was close by, so Trill did not get knocked back far enough to be out of range and lands the mana rift. Now flying up in the air. And what I love with this rain from above is Trill is either in metamorphosis, meleeing people, maximizing his damage, and if metamorphosis isn't up, then he's flying up in the air doing percent health damage. He's maximizing absolutely every single global cooldown while nailing pretty much every single mana rift outside of the ones that are out of his control to land. And if they keep playing like this, I mean, the defense still looks solid. They're rotating through Iron Bark Blur effectively. They've rotated through their 3-minute cooldowns effectively. Their defense is impenetrable. Their offense is on point. And I'm happy to see Method Orange come off of their more honestly embarrassing performance at the spring finals, come back here for the summer season as strong as they are. This is the Method Orange that won BlizzCon.
Yeah, it definitely is. And Rubcub is just so low on mana at this point. I don't know if he's ever going to be able to recover it. Rubcub, Jamili, Roasties all rotting down. Mez has just been keeping chains of ice on Roasties the entire game, making it really difficult for him to chase down Trill. In the meantime, he's just been sitting on Jamili, interrupting everything. Lightning Lasso over onto Mez. That gets Ghoul stunned. Jamili must be incredibly frustrated at this point in the game. They need to try to find some windows of opportunity. Who can they take down? Mez has a lot of defensive cooldowns. Trill has every defensive cooldown. There's just no openings here for M2KC, and they're behind on mana. They're running out of time. What can they possibly do, Sid?
Desperate attack on Seedu. I mean, try and kill him in a kidney shot, lightning lasso. Trill has all defense. Mez has most of his defense. Seedu has his as well. I mean, it's pretty much just game over at this point. Method Orange have just played clinically, and to my point, basically perfectly, unless they make a massive mistake. Trill flying up in the air. He's going to be doing big damage
from
the spies. So much damage on Jamili. Zero mana remaining for Rubcub.
Oh!
And they're just overwhelmed at this point. Jamili looking like he's going to fall. Desperation Lightning Lasso interrupted instantly by Trill. Rubcub just wants to drink, but his shaman is dead. He's never going to drink. Everyone is stunned, and Jamili is going to fall. Method Orange closed this out and put M2KC on match point.
Method Orange.
Also like M2KC, who could definitely use, you know, a melee expert. You know, we see Nick. We see Waz, they're playing Windwalkers, they're playing, you know, all kinds of stuff. I would love to see that from Roasties as well.
All right, we're here on match point. Method Orange look to advance 3-0. Probably, I mean, this is the first time we've seen Jamili Windwalker. Not going to count him out just yet. Perhaps he can surprise us all. Jamili is definitely a mastermind when it comes to multi-classing, but first time on a tournament setting. Method Orange are not hesitant, immediately going after Rubcub and bringing the heat.
Yeah, a lot of damage early on to Rubcub. What is he going to do to survive? This is going to have to be really good counter pressure on this matchup. Rubcub goes down to 3% health, gets the Divine Shield off. Not the best start here for M2KC. Has Method Orange had to use a single defensive? Just the Iron Bark, and that's really not that much.
It really is not that much, Vinruki. I would have liked to have seen a different composition, something more with some more mains. I mean, Rubcub is the main here. Rosita is obviously good at Death Knight and Demon Hunter. He has a lot of experience. He was kind of the Trinity Destroyer way back, years back, when he was playing the Death Knight and the Demon Hunter. But this composition, you know, it's
blessing and protection.
I guess one more cooldown out of the way. I was going to say, you know, maybe people think the Windwalker Death Knight's pretty straightforward. It's like target the healer, zug zug, run down, do damage. But right now, they're not running at the healer, and they're not doing damage. They're kind of just doing a whole lot of nothing while Rubcub dies. Finally, some pressure on Trill as he's at half health, but more than enough defensive options. Mana Rifts are sinking in, and this is incredibly one-sided. I thought we saw in a game earlier that was the most one-sided game, but this one may actually turn out to be more one-sided.
Yeah, I mean, only time will tell. We'll have to see how it goes. Trill gets the double Chaos Nova on Jamili on Rubcub. Another Mana Rift lands. And here's the thing. Although Rubcub might be able to survive, these consistent mana rifts are really putting him far behind on men. You can see Cedar's around 70%. Rubcub already down to around 40%. Mez is just all over him right now. Trill's trying to get in line of sight as well. If they can consistently land these stuns, Rubcub's going to be in so much trouble.
I feel like Jamili's like a little kid, like, Mez, notice me. I'm hitting you. Please, Mez, notice me. And Mez just keeps walking at Rubcub, smacking him. Finally having to acknowledge Jamili here as Touch of Death will do a lot of damage.
Not that much.
I guess it's not that much. Well, they actually overlap with Icebound Fortitude. Maybe a bit of a blunder there on Method Orange's part, but they still have a lot more defensive cooldowns to go through. Whereas Rubcub, I mean, if he gets crowd controlled on this Avenging Wrath at all, disrupted whatsoever, dispelled on his Divine Favor and interrupted, he dies. Divine Favor, no interrupt.
Ooh.
Clutch heal. Rubcub stays alive as a result. Bit of a risky gamble, but I mean, he's got to do something. He's trying to keep his team alive for them to try and create some sort of pressure, but Jamili Windwalker is just tickling Miz.
Rubcub gets ripped in. Fel Eruption gets cast out. Another mana rift just for you, Rubcub. Down to 10% mana. Seedu asphyxiates done as Rosita Jones and Jamili trying to put that Windwalker Death Knight pressure onto Seedu, but
dead.
He easily deals with that. Rubcub gets interrupted. M2KC gets sent down to the lower bracket, and Method Orange, they advance to the grand final.
feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up, 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.